Perfect. Morning, Bernadette. Whoa, Mama! Phone. No, where's the phone? Oh, come on. Huh. Okay. Oh, I'm coming, Mama. Doc, we got Breach.
What? Kendall?
Breach! Breach birth? Easy, Bernadette, I know.
There's no easy way to say this, but you gotta reach in.
Reaching in!
Okay, you need to push it back in as far as you can.
We can do this. Okay, here we go. I know. Here we go, Mama.
Hello? I heard the screams. You need a hand?
Doc, hang on. It's not a good time, mister. Okay, what's next?
Hold her forward with one hand, and then grasp a leg with the other. Bend the hock and lift it upward, rotating it as you lift.
Wait, what?
I'm sorry, but
can
if you let...
Can you go slower or use word pictures or something?
I think I can...
Oh, this is not working!
I'm a vet!
Thanks, Doc. Bye. Grab some gloves. You're up. Oh, it's beautiful.
Yeah, he is.
Boy, you showed up just in the nick of time. I'm Kendall.
Clint. Huh. Oh. Sorry.
Well, nobody said life wasn't messy.
Amen to that.
I'd like to think that you're a godsend, but I'm assuming you came for something other than saving Bernadette the cow.
Is the cow officially part of her name?
She's named after my aunt, who is just as stubborn. The cow just helps us distinguish the difference.
I'm sure she's honored.
Not as honored as my Uncle Earl. Do you see that handsome guy over there? That's his namesake.
So you're Kendall Riley.
Guilty.
I figured. You got your daddy's smile.
You knew my father?
I did. I was tore up to hear he passed.
How'd you know him?
The rodeo. Long time ago. He was good to me. He talked me through my first Bronco. Let me borrow his gloves. I want to give him back. Man's gloves are important to him.
He gave them to you. Would you like a cup of coffee?
I would. Thank you.
This ranch is all yours now?
Yep. I inherited it.
How many head?
220. Well, 221, thanks to you.
Right.
They're all organic.
I wasn't aware anybody did that around here.
We're about this close to getting our certificate.
Certificate?
Becoming certified organic is a very long process. You have to develop a plan, and then you have to get it approved. And by it, I mean everything. From the substances we use, to the processes, to the tilling, the grazing, all of it. And an inspector comes out once a year for 3 years.
Pretty thorough?
You have to be completely chemical free. I have to keep perfect records, sales receipt of all the food the cows eat.
Sounds like a commitment.
It's become my life. But hopefully tomorrow, it's over. It's our last inspection.
Oh, that's incredible. I wish you the best of luck. I hope it all works out for you. The world could use more organic farmers.
Thank you. Oh, speaking of the wide world,
Kendall!
Here comes a slice of it right now.
Hey, girl!
Sit back and enjoy the show with these two.
Hey, you guys!
Marcus, you're back from Michigan.
Kendall, I missed you.
How was your trip?
Who's the cowboy?
We just met. Clint, this is Marcus.
Marcus Montoya.
Ignore him. I'm Memphis, proprietor of the I Will Cut You hair and nail salon.
Well, it's a pleasure.
Ever had a manicure?
I once had a horse bite my nail off.
I'd say.
Marcus and I have studied organic farming together in New York. Now he's my accountant, bookkeeper, marketing agent. Actually, the list of what you aren't is shorter.
What is he is more important.
Clint is a veterinarian. He just helped me with Bernadette's baby.
Better you than me.
We had our hands full. It's a pleasure to meet you guys, but I better get going. I'll let you guys get to it.
Mm-hmm. What did I tell you about those two?
No, I'd been warned. Thank you.
Welcome.
Call me, in case Bernadette needs anything. The cow, not your aunt.
Will do. Take care.
You too.
All right, let's see it.
It's a classy font. Memorable design.
Do you know who that was?
Clint the veterinarian?
No, Clint McCree. Brick McCree's son.
Oh.
Brick, the man that's trying to buy your ranch?
Mm-hmm.
Is that why Clint was here? Did he say anything about it?
No, he didn't say anything.
Oh, what a snake in the grass! Wait, you didn't tell him anything, did you?
About what?
The ranch!
Well, I told him the inspector was coming tomorrow.
Why would you do that?
I don't know. It just came up. Words happen.
Did he ask about anything else?
He asked how many cattle I have.
He's a spy. Great.
If he is a spy, he's a terrible one. He gave me a card with his name on it.
Oh no, you trust me. If he's a McCree, he's up to no good. They're all bandits to the bone, and you know that! Brick McCree.
You're fired, Pete.
But Mr. McCree, it's Christmas.
Humbug.
I can fix it, just give me more time to
get off or get thrown off. You got 3 seconds. Three?
Mr. McCree, please. I got a wife and a kid that I gotta feed.
Two? He's not gonna ask you again, Pete. Boss not happy with your work.
Okay. Okay.
That boy can't fix anything. Just buy a new tractor. Yes, sir. What about the girl? Kendall's got one last inspection tomorrow. I mean, what if this organic stuff really does sell? Well, then you take care of it. Yes, sir. Who's that? That's my son. Well, look what the wind blew in.
Hey, Pop.
Hey, Clint.
Hank? Been a long time.
You got something to do? Sure thing, boss. You look good, boy.
So do you, old man. Considering.
Who told you about that?
Ma.
She did she? Well, I suppose it's only polite to ask. How's she doing?
Ask her yourself.
A million? It's been a minute. You look good.
You look better than I expected.
What are you doing here?
I came to spend Christmas with my son, who came to spend it with his father, in case it was his last.
Well, you know, Will, there's a lot going on around here now. Suppose I could use your help.
Let's just start with lunch. I'll see what I can rustle up.
You know, I'd like to get my hands dirty while I'm here. Chip in when and where I can, but we're gonna have to ease into this. Okay? Slowly.
Yeah, you and me both.
Place is a mess.
Is it a good thing or a bad thing when he's writing?
I don't know. So, how long does it take an intelligent man like yourself to go to school to be an inspector?
Huh? Oh. Normal amount of time, I suppose.
Wow. I bet you were top of your class, weren't you?
No. Somewhere in the middle.
Genius. So, do you got a name? Or do all your girlfriends call you Mr. Inspector?
No, I don't have a girlfriend.
No? You're joking.
No.
Lucky me. You know, my mascara's organic. What do you think? The lipstick, too. You want a sample? Did you see that? He blushed.
How is this helping us?
It means he's human. Oh, I got this. Don't worry.
Miss Riley, I'm sorry, but, we have a problem.
What do you mean? No, I did everything right. I followed the rules for 3 years. I triple-checked everything.
Except for one major thing. You signed in the wrong place.
So you mean that...
Yep. You're certified.
Spencer, get in here!
Now...
Come on.
Were you, really interested in seeing my pictures from my trip to El Paso, or were you just flirting with me to get the certificate? Figures. Fall for it every time. Good effort, though. And I really support what you guys are doing here. It's pretty amazing.
Thank you, Spencer.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. You guys.
Oh,
yes. You added those lashes.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Working it.
Y'all scandalous.
Well, they are.
Woman's got to do what a woman's got to do.
That's right.
So that's it then? You're good to go?
Yep, we're officially organic.
I know it's cost you. Your dad'd be proud.
Yeah. Do you have any idea how expensive it is for the inspection alone? Mm. And then doing it 3 times? Girl practically lost everything, but she did it anyway.
Well, I couldn't have done it without you guys.
And she already has a buyer, too.
Really?
Damn. Top choice foods. In a couple weeks, they buy almost the whole herd.
Oh, you know, that's wonderful.
Oh, thank you. It's going to be great.
So how long do we have the pleasure of your company this time?
I don't know. I like it here.
Memphis give you that do?
Yeah. You like it?
I love it. Who do you keep looking at over there?
Shh, don't be so obvious.
He's a McCree, but he said my dad was good to him. That they met at the rodeo.
He came to spy on her.
Mm-hmm. So is that why Clint's here to help his dad? Y'all know he has cancer, right?
Yeah.
Now, how do you know that?
Sheila Michaels works at the hospital.
Lean back.
So, Kendall, how long have your fathers hated each other?
Since before Clint and Ho were born.
Not that I even know why.
So do you like her? I think it's great.
Does she know?
No.
You know, I heard it was a property dispute. Brick swindled land from your daddy or something. Mm.
What don't you hear, girl?
No, I heard that too. See?
Bull hockey. This is the 20th century.
21st.
You can't just steal land like that anymore. All that property used to belong to Brick. The Last Chance Ranch was Brick's land. That's what I know.
Well, then how did Kendall's daddy get it?
I don't know. And neither does anybody else, I reckon.
Except Brick.
You know, I bet it was hush money. Your daddy found out that Brick was laundering cash or something.
Do you think so?
Yes, you know that's how.
Oh, no, stop that. Brick might be bad, but he ain't evil.
Oh, speak for yourself. Mm-hmm.
Now, if you folks gonna pride yourself in being the best town gossip, at least get your facts straight.
Granddaddy, bad and evil may not be the same fruit, but they're in the same bowl.
Yeah, and that bowl ain't jail. Bad is selfish. Evil is malicious. There's a difference, baby girl.
Well, why don't you tell her?
She's got too much going on. And our friendship means too much to me to be risking it like that.
Mm-hmm. And who are you calling gossips anyhow?
Mm-hmm. All I'm saying is you got a lot of information on everybody else in this town.
Oh, no, we don't.
You don't?
No.
No.
Oh.
Excuse me. How many of you have binoculars in your purses?
I do. But I don't always carry a purse.
Mm-hmm. And how many of y'all have professional FBI listening devices in there? No further questions, Your Honor.
You know, I don't even know why you hang here, Granddaddy. This is a hair salon, and you're as bald as my elbow.
It's a great place to meet women.
Oh, stop. He's a man.
5, 4, 3, 2.
Merry Christmas, Mom and Dad. So it became official today. Kendall Riley, an organic farmer. I know it wasn't really your thing, Dad, but it's my thing. And you guys were always so supportive when I was passionate about something. I'm so excited and scared.
Merry Christmas.
Thanks. I wish you guys were here.
Ooh, hot chocolate.
And Mom, I just want to tell you the planning for the Cattleman's Christmas Ball is going really well. I don't have a lot of time to organize it, but Memphis is doing a lot of the work, sweetheart. And the money from this year is going to cancer research at the hospital. So I just wanted to honor you by doing something good for someone else.
How's Bernadette the cow?
Well, come see for yourself.
Oh, she's looking good. The little one, he's eating well.
Yeah, we're fine.
Fantastic. But you know, I could examine him.
We're good. Thanks, I can take it from here.
All right, then. Well, you have my number.
Oh, yes. Mr. McCree, I have your number.
Oh. I see. Ms. Riley, I'm not my father, you know.
Really? Were you his spy?
His spy? Look, I know that he's not the most popular man in town. It's kind of the reason I left. Guilt by association, you know. I swore I'd never come back.
Why are you telling me this?
I'm only here because he has cancer.
Yeah, I heard.
I didn't say it for sympathy. I wanted to drop by and just pay my respects and tell you that your daddy was more of a father to me than...
I just wanted to check on the little one. I'm sorry to bother.
It wasn't sympathy. My mother had cancer, too.
Yeah, I know.
And even though your father's polluting my pond and breaking my tractor and manipulating the market, I wouldn't wish that on my worst enemy.
He's really doing all that? I'm sorry. You have a nice day.
You too. What are you looking at?
You okay?
Oh, yeah, just pills.
When's your next appointment? I can drive you if you like.
Well, thank you, but I don't need you to do that for me.
Okay.
Lillian? You know, since the three of us are here right now, maybe we gotta sit down to a meal together. Try to catch up a little bit. Nothing fancy, nothing official, just...
Family?
Yeah, family. What do you think?
I think we can manage that.
Good.
I'll tell Clint.
Okay, then.
Just a few more steps on the certification paperwork. First, I need the original deed.
Okay. Let's see.
What?
Lillian McCree.
What?
Clint's mom.
What are you talking about?
It says here that the ranch was sold to my father by Lillian.
Brooke McCree's wife?
Ex-wife.
Scandalous.
Guess what she sold it to him for?
$150,000?
Huh.
$100,000? $50,000? $25,000? $1,000?
$1.
No.
She sold it to him for $1.
It's gotta be a mistake.
Gotta be. Hello? Hey, Kendall. How you doing? Oh, hi, Lawrence. You must have heard that we've gone official.
Top choice.
Mm-hmm. Yesterday morning. We're just finishing up some paperwork, and I'm actually glad you called because I wanted to confirm your purchase at the market for the...
Yeah, that's why I was calling.
I'm sorry?
Well,
I don't understand. We had an agreement. Yes, I know verbal commitments are non-binding, but can you at least explain why? Where did you hear that? Of course. All right. Bye-bye.
Top choice backed out.
Brick McCree.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Mrs. McCree.
Hi, Kendall.
Hi. What are you... I am surprised to see you here.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to be staying at the house through Christmas. Mr. McCree needed my help with some things, so... How are you?
I've been better. Your husband around?
15 years, not my husband. And, yes, but he's really busy.
So am I, ma'am.
Come on in.
Yeah, well, don't make me come after you, Daniel, because you know I will. Yeah.
Hey. Kendall Riley's here to see you.
You know, that would work, but you'd have to put it in writing.
You have company, Brick.
I'm gonna have to call you back. My ex-wife is yelling at me, and she's brought a friend. Yeah. How may I help you, Miss Riley?
Why do you keep meddling with my ranch? I am not your competition.
Trust me, I don't think of you as competition.
Then why do you keep sabotaging me?
I beg your pardon?
Top choice.
Oh, yeah, well, Lawrence is a friend of mine. And over a biscuit and coffee, I did mention to my friend that whereas you have had your certificate for one day, I had a better deal on a sure thing. You are not a sure thing, and
this
I had to...
This is hard enough for me without you making it impossible.
Look, I'm just trying to do a good thing here.
Yeah, you're the one who does the good things. That's what... Clean these for me, please. Thank you. You know why my ranch is so big? Why I'm so successful?
No, why?
Well, it's because I feed thousands and thousands of people. Regular folks, not just those who can afford what's fancy. And the best thing you could do, and this is very good advice...
No, I'm listening.
...would be to sell the land back to me.
Back to you?
Yeah. You inherited an unplayable hand. It's not your fault. Robert Riley was a fine cowboy, but a terrible businessman. Everybody knows that.
If I fail, let it be because I failed, not because you cheated.
It's not cheating. It's just business.
Hey, Pop, that new calf gun.
Good day, Mr. McCree. Lillian.
What's all that about?
How can you still be so bitter? How many years has it been? Robert Riley's been dead for 3 years, and you're still bent on vengeance, and now you're going to take it out on his daughter? She had nothing to do with any of that.
What is going on?
It's just business. What is so hard to understand about that?
If that girl could affect your bottom line by a dime, I'd be shocked.
I have to think about the future. That's what I'm doing.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Everything affects everything, and I want to leave my son an inheritance that's worth something.
What makes you think I even want this place?
Because you're smart enough to know that this place offers more to you than poodles with kennel cough.
If you cared enough to even ask, his business doesn't even deal with dogs at all. Clean your own stinking glasses.
What are you doing to her?
I didn't ask her to come back.
Not Mom. Kendall.
You should do us both a favor, son. Stay away from the Riley girl.
What are you thinking? What are you calculating?
How far back does your property go?
It goes all the way to the McCree line, and then it... Wait, why?
I'm just considering all options.
No, not that option.
You asked me to go over your operating budget and evaluate your situation.
I know, but that is
why
not...
Why not just sell the back option?
No.
If Brick made an offer even half as good as the last one...
I am not selling any part of this ranch. We need every inch of it for the cattle, and I'm not losing my family farm after only 3 years. It's all I have left.
I'm not telling you to lose it. I'm just thinking more like amputate part of it to save the rest of it.
Marcus.
Okay. You're right. Okay, so what's this item here?
Food.
Wait, cow food?
Yes.
Okay, and so what's this item here?
My food.
Cows are eating better than you are.
Well, there's 221 of them and one of me.
Perhaps your operating budget might look a little better if you cut out all the foods that come in nugget form.
I don't have time to cook.
I work with an organic farmer who's too busy running her organic farm to eat anything but processed chicken in the shape of a boot.
I'm gonna need you to be serious with me.
I'm trying to be serious, but
You don't seem open to...
Open to what? What exactly are you suggesting?
If you don't find a buyer, then we're gonna have to go to auction. And there's only one left until summer. And the numbers are saying that if you don't sell enough cows, you're done.
Really? Family dinner, huh?
It was your father's idea.
Better late than never, I guess.
Hey.
Hey.
It's good to see the two of you here. Sorry I'm late. Wow.
It's bleak in here, Pop.
Oh, yeah? Well, I don't eat in here much.
Ever?
You know what you could use?
What's that?
Christmas tree. Right there.
You know your father's not a fan of Christmas trees.
No trees, no carols, no presents. I never understood it. It's just one day, Pop.
Well, I guess I was always too busy making sure you had what you needed for the other 364.
Yeah, most Christmas movies are based on characters that think like that.
Well, you see, I'm on the right track.
They're usually the villains.
Touché.
If there's anyone who could use some Christmas spirit right now, Pop, it's you.
I got the Christmas spirit. Ho, 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 humbug. Rudolph the Red. I got it all. Just, test me.
You're closer than you know, old man.
Of course. That makes sense. I know it was last minute, but it was worth a shot.
I'm so sorry, darling.
Merry Christmas. Give my love to Ida.
I will.
Hi.
Hey. I'm kind of busy. Did you need something?
I just came by to check on our baby. Calf.
Doug is fine.
You named him.
Yeah.
And how's Mom?
Bernadette is fine, too. All right. I can tell you are not going to leave until you say what you need to. Go on. Come on, then.
Okay, so what's the deal with...
The deal is that I am trying to stay afloat here. And your father keeps trying to drown me on purpose, and I don't know why. But I do know why you keep coming here. Don't give me that puppy dog face. Do you think I'm not onto you? Coming over to check on me, asking me about my cattle, asking me about the inspections. I don't know why your family is so intent on ruining my life.
I was gonna say, what's the deal with the artificial sweetener? I mean, you run an organic farm and you're putting that in your body? Talk about ruining your life.
I like the taste of fake chicken nuggets and I don't want cavities.
Hey, I'd like to tell you that I have nothing to do with this, but I don't think you'd believe me. The truth is, nobody controls my dad. The best thing I could do was get away from him so he couldn't control me. Now, I don't know why he does what he does. I don't even think he knows why he does what he does. He just does. And you're right. I didn't come here just to check on the calf. I came to check on you and to apologize to you for him.
All right, let's restock that fridge. Well, well, well. Look who came crawling back.
Hi, Mitch.
It's Marcus.
Marcus.
Mr. Clint McCoward?
I mean, got a lot of things in my life, some of them true, but a coward isn't one of them.
You know, I've never met your pappy before, but I picture him with a black twirly mustache. Does he have a black twirly mustache?
He's gonna hit you in your face, Marcus, if you don't shut up.
You know, just say the word and I'll fight for your honor.
I will fight for my own honor, thank you very much. Now just stop it. Something's wrong. Oh,
out the back fence. A couple dozen cows are loose.
Can you ride?
A horse?
I ride.
Okay. Marcus, patch a fence, okay?
Yeah, I can do that.
And get the cow. Oh, forever. I gotta get some new wire.
I'll go with you to the store.
Well, you guys can go. I got a little more work to do anyways.
Thanks.
Can I catch a ride? Come on, Santa.
That's where my parents got engaged.
In the gazebo?
Mm-hmm. It was the night of the Christmas tree lighting 30-something years ago. I was just saying hi.
To your parents?
Yeah. They always spent a lot of time here. I learned to ride my bike right over there in that grass. The ranch had too many cow pies.
My dad always used to say it's just extra padding.
My favorite time when I was little, though, was early spring and fall. We would come here and get an ice cream, listen to the local high school band practice, because the sports teams would take their field, so they would practice here.
Yeah, I used to be on the sports team.
Of course you were. I played the clarinet in high school.
No wonder we never met.
This was always a little slice of heaven.
I see what you mean.
So how well did you know my dad?
Well, he's a good man.
He always used to say, when caring for an animal, half the battle
is getting them to trust you.
Yeah. What did your dad think about you being under the wing of O'Reilly?
Are you kidding? He didn't know. There's no way to prove. Not just because all O'Reillys are scoundrels.
Thank you.
Nah, to be honest, there's not much he does approve of. He hates that I'm a vet. He thinks I'm bucking against his wishes. Eventually I'll come around.
Why don't you?
Why don't I what?
Come around? He's successful. You still get to work with animals.
I'd still have to work with him. After I saw the way you treated my mother, I didn't want to have anything to do with him.
Didn't want. Has your opinion changed?
No. I guess I'd hope that cancer would have changed him, or at least given him a new perspective. You know, my mom told me that our dads used to be friends.
No.
Yeah?
I never heard that part.
Yeah, supposedly they were close.
Then what happened?
I don't know. Seems nobody wants to talk about it.
Hmm.
Frosty the Cowboy. Yeehaw.
Oh no, that is too far.
You can't put a cowboy hat on baby Jesus. Here, let me fix this. Jesus is perfect the way he is. There.
I don't think there were cowboys in the Bible. Good fix.
Yes!
We should get to the hardware store.
Yeah. That is a solid 8. We got an 8!
We've got an 8!
What's an 8?
An 8 is a salacious scandal involving people we all know. Oh, my word! Okay, quiet down. I think we're all here. Vivian, is this really an 8?
Oh, it's an 8.
Okay, because if it's really a 4 or even a 6, we are removing you off the emergency text list. Mm-hmm.
Do you think I would even risk getting taken off of the list? I have got an 8.
Mm-hmm. Prove it.
I saw Clint McCree and Kendall Riley together.
Vivian, we knew this.
He's a spy.
Yeah.
That's old news. What? He's a vet. Out there checking on that calf.
It wasn't at the ranch. It was in town, near the gazebo, where he touched her cheek.
Oh, that's really geez. Sweet.
Come on. That's a? Heck, that don't mean nothing.
Okay, so how often do you touch a woman's cheek, Granddad?
I don't know. How often do you?
I'm a hairdresser.
Okay, you two. Now, what happened after he touched your cheek? Mm-hmm.
They went into the hardware store.
Now, what could they possibly want in there?
Wire.
Probably fixing a fence.
Follow-up question. Was there any smiling?
Yes, by both parties. And once she even looked at him and giggled.
Okay,
that's very interesting. Okay, Vivian, this is definitely an 8.
I told you.
A Riley and a McCree together. Somebody better check the temperature because H-E double hockey sticks just froze over.
Amen.
Well, yeah, she's been working by herself for the last 3 years, but she worked for many years before that with her father.
See you right. Later.
I understand. Thank you for your time.
Everything okay?
Somehow, Kendall has gained the reputation among organic meat producers that she's inexperienced and in over her head. That she doesn't know what she's doing.
How'd she get that reputation?
I think we both know the answer to that. Wait, do you have any influence around here?
Almost none.
Yeah, I assume so.
Hey, are you planning on moving out here and helping out on the ranch?
I live in Michigan.
Right, but thought maybe you guys would...
You thought what?
What?
Are you two seeing each other?
Who?
This guy.
Nah, we're not together. No, actually, I got eyes for someone else.
But if you're really falling for her, then there's gotta be something you could do about all this.
Never said I was falling for her. I'll see you later.
Memphis!
Oh my gosh, oh my gosh.
I've got a 9!
A 9? Oh my word!
It appears your father is trying to try.
Nothing, cowboy.
Who's breaking who, mister? Get control of him. Come on now.
Take a look at your cows down by the barn.
He's done. I want a cowboy that can ride a horse, not just hold on.
Yes, sir.
Not enough room for them in those pens.
Stop thinking of cattle as people.
Stop thinking of people as cattle.
Good comeback.
Town hasn't changed much.
Yeah, well, I'd be disappointed if it did. Actually, I take that back. You being here is one change I approve of.
I wish you could have been under other circumstances.
Well, maybe some sons wouldn't have come back at all. I don't know that I would have, from my daddy. Good grief, he was a bad man. He's a man of regret. Too much regret makes a man hard.
So does hate.
Nope. That's different. You best be careful where you put your heart, son. Careful who you let in. Hey, I want to show you something. Come on. Hey, girl. Hey.
Wow. She's beautiful.
Yeah. She's yours.
You give her to me?
I bought her for you.
I don't have anywhere to keep her.
Yeah, well, that's true. But maybe you could keep her here. Might entice you to come around a little more often.
You sure are putting a lot of effort into showing me how much you've changed.
Well, you know what would prove it to me more than anything else?
What's that?
Leave Kendall Riley alone. I know you're the one who's been spreading rumors about her. I know you had her fence cut. As far as I can gather, this isn't the first time that you've meddled. Now I'm asking you, just back off. Don't be that man. Don't be like Granddad.
You know, whether you like me or not, I am your father.
She is not a threat.
No, she's an enemy.
Are you listening to yourself?
The Rileys have done nothing but cause this family pain.
What?
They have betrayed us. They have taken from us.
How?
I know you're smitten. I can see it. Let me give you a lesson in loyalty.
Loyalty?
When a family draws a line, nobody in the clan crosses it. That's an ironclad rule.
Even if she wasn't a factor, we'd still be having this conversation.
And why is that?
Let me let you in on a little secret. I think the world of Kendall and what she's trying to do. And I thought the world of her father.
Well, that is because you did not know Robert Riley.
The rodeo. He taught me everything I know.
You were friends with this man?
We weren't friends. He was a father I never had.
Pop, why did you really come back? What do you want from me?
Nothing. I'm just trying to do what's right.
What's right? You have no idea what you're walking into.
You're right. I have no idea, but I am sick of whatever it is. I'm gonna invite her to dinner. Family dinner. And I'll stay here and I'll help out around the ranch. Otherwise, I am out of here. Cancer or no cancer, Christmas or not.
You think you can humble me? Is that it?
That's my offer, old man.
Yeah. No, thank you for calling us back.
Okay, yeah, one moment. Yeah, I'll be right with you. Just one second. Okay.
You need to take this.
Hello? Yes, this is she.
Hi, my name is Kevin Davis from Shoemaker.
Yes.
I'm in a bit of a bind and I'm looking for a new piece of life.
That's perfect. Yes. Yes, we have a deal. Okay, great. I'll see you then. Okay, bye-bye. We have a buyer.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Call every farmhand you know.
Yeah.
And we need to get the cattle into the pens for sorting.
What about the bad boards in the loading chute?
We'll fix them. Do you know where we can get a front loader? We need to soften the runway.
Yeah, I can call Gus.
Great. And Clint.
Clint?
We need every hand we can get. Okay.
Okay.
Thanks for coming out. If we can get you to level out that dirt mound over there, we'll be all set. Thank you.
That takes care of the cattle. Now all I have to do is get your father to keep his hands out of it.
Come to dinner tonight, and you can tell him yourself.
They want me to come over for dinner.
I want you to come over for dinner. Think of it as phase one of the peace talks.
We have a lot of work to do around here, and I'm
not
sure...
Can't work 24-7. Listen, this is the first time I've even seen my old man trying. Please, while the iron's hot. It would mean a lot to me.
Well, I'm sorry Brick's late. They say he's on his way.
It's fine.
It's typical.
I'm sorry to hear about his condition.
Yeah, me too. I know you can empathize. I really respect you, Kendall. I've always respected your family, and I'm so happy that my son can see that in you as well.
Thank you. What I'm doing at the ranch, it's really nothing special. I'm just trying to do what I think is best.
Yeah, well, sitting fearlessly at the table of the enemy is... Well, it speaks volumes, even whether you acknowledge it or not.
It's funny, I don't think of him as an enemy, even though he tries to make himself one. He's always hated me for what I've had. And I feel sorry for what he didn't.
You know, hate is something that most people learn from their parents. Your folks didn't have an ounce in them.
Did you know my parents well?
Oh, yeah. Your mom and I go way back.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, good. So someone can finally tell me what this feud is all about that I'm in the middle of.
Yes, please.
I don't think we should be dredging up stuff.
It's like dredged up every day, whether you talk about it or not.
Mom.
Okay.
What is she getting?
Probably a gun, just in case he walks in while she's telling us.
Now, first of all, this is, it's not a feud. A feud requires more than one person. This is more like a vendetta. It starts and it ends with Brick, just Brick. The character of a man definitely emerges when he's been wronged.
Wronged by who?
By love. And no, I'm not the woman. I couldn't compete with her. Not even in memory.
My mother?
Your mother and Brick were engaged.
What?
That's Dad with her mom. Wait, we're not.
No. Their wedding was the talk of the town. But then Lois changed her mind and Brick was publicly humiliated. It was supposed to be a Christmas wedding.
Hence Dad's aversion to all things Christmas.
When the engagement broke, Brick poured himself into this ranch. I think he was trying to prove to everybody that, you know, he wasn't a failure. And then we started dating. And in retrospect, I think he wanted to get married because he wanted to show that, well, to everybody and himself, that he was over Lois. I knew he didn't love me the same way, but I kind of thought he was gonna learn too.
But you loved him.
I still do. Even when I can't stand to be in the same room with him. I just hope you two never have to understand this kind of love. So when the dust settled from the divorce, I took a little revenge myself.
What?
I was awarded part of the ranch in the settlement, and I sold it.
To my father. For a dollar. No. No!
I think I should have had this framed like the ones in the restaurant.
Mom.
Hey, it wasn't that malicious. I loved your mother, too. And after all this happened, her family was disgraced. They almost lost everything. And then she married your dad, rodeo cowboy, and was pretty clear they weren't going to make ends meet. So I sold it to him. But I gave it to her. Brick sends his apologies. There's apparently a problem with coyotes in the northern range, and he suggests we start without him.
Like I said, typical.
Here you go.
Better with you than in this dusty old box. Merry Christmas, Kendall.
Thank you.
I miss this. And the city has got everything else, but not this.
Thanks for the effort tonight with the dinner.
Sorry about my dad.
Honestly, I'm kind of glad he didn't come. It was a really great time with your mom.
For tonight, I don't think I'd ever considered life from his perspective. I don't think he's ever shared enough that I could. I mean, I know he's not right. But at least I could feel his hurt. I hope it's true. And people really can change.
People change. Especially around Christmas. Well, I have to get up early. I told Memphis I'd help her with decorations.
What is the shindig?
The Cattleman's Christmas Ball. You never heard of it.
It sounds fancy.
Right? And I'm in charge of it.
Don't you have a ranch to run?
I do. But this is tradition. It's important.
Well, it sounds like a can't-miss event.
That's the goal. Good night.
So, do people ask people to go to this thing? I mean, do people ask people out to this thing?
Like a homecoming?
No. I mean, well, yeah, in the sense that, you know, I pick you up and...
Kind of like a football player picking up a clarinet player for a dance.
I mean, that's one example of what I'm trying to understand here.
Yeah, just trying to understand what you're asking here.
You think heads would explode if I asked you out?
Yes.
Kind of makes you want to do it, doesn't it?
Definitely.
Okay, then. We're about to become the biggest piece of gossip this town's ever spread.
We are. I'm just doing it for Memphis and the other girls at the hair salon. I'll see you then. Good night.
Good night, Kendall.
Mom, you didn't have to do the dishes. I was just changing.
Oh, really?
Cold start.
I won't. But did you kiss her?
What do you think? No, I didn't kiss her. When did he get back?
Yeah, right after you guys left.
Those were some convenient coyotes.
Yeah.
Where is he? You're lying.
What?
You're a liar.
Holster that finger and tell me what the heck you're talking about.
What is going on?
Dad's not dying.
What's he talking about?
These are vitamins, boosters. He's in remission.
Hey, I only found out about a week ago.
And you didn't tell us?
Well, I was going to, but I wanted to make sure before I got everybody's hopes up.
He manipulated us.
That was not that calculated, trust me.
Trust you?
Yeah, I'm in remission. That's all it is. It's not the same as being in the clear. It was hard enough to tell your mom I had cancer. Much less tell the two of you that I suddenly don't, with the chance that maybe now I gotta tell you I have it again.
What's he even talking
I'm
about?
I'm just trying to spare you this way and that way of the thing, that's all.
It's still so selfish, Brick.
Selfish?
It's selfish? I'm thinking of you!
No, you're thinking of you!
There has always been a small part of me that believed you could be a good man, a good father. But once again,
oh, you almost made it, Brick. You almost had a son again.
Lillian, please.
You know, you never needed cancer to get him back. You didn't need to buy him a horse. You didn't need to help that girl with a buyer. All you needed to do was reach out and say, I'm sorry.
I never helped that girl. Don't put that on me. I never helped that girl find a buyer. I would never help her, Riley.
Are you kidding me?
I was thinking of you!
You okay, Mr. McCree?
Oh, yeah. I'm Peaches. Consider yourself unbridled.
Hey, you got Clint Sell. Leave a message after the beep.
Hey, it's me.
Still got a lot to do before the ball in a few hours. Turns out I could really use your help around here. Maybe you're getting ready for the ball tonight. Finally taming those eyebrows. Are you at the hair salon right now? Give me a call back.
No, I'm on my way now. Yeah, just like we talked about. Just have the boys ready.
Look,
you are a vision.
What he said. Oh, well, thank you for helping with all of this and with me.
That's right.
Oh, my mom would have loved this.
She would have also loved this dress.
It's her favorite color.
So, where's your date?
You haven't seen him?
You guys didn't come together?
Oh, well, I figured he was running late, so I just came on my own. He'll turn up.
Yeah.
Well, how about a dance?
I would love to.
What are you up to, Hank?
Hey! Get out of here!
That Clint?
You better go home.
Get out of here now! Both of you, out!
Go home before I call you daddy.
You just can't leave her alone, can you? Call him. 3-on-1 isn't enough.
Oh, you think I need these boys? Your daddy pays me to do his dirty work.
Look at that, boys.
Spare the rod, spoil the child.
Can that all you got, Hank?
What?
Get him! That's enough. We got a job to do. Take his Jeep.
Hey, you got Clint's cell. Leave a message after the beep.
Where's Kendall? Have you seen Kendall? Has anybody seen Kendall?
Look, Santa's gotta go.
I'm not done.
You're gonna get your boombox, okay?
Xbox.
Hey, you work for Brick?
No, I work for Kendall. Have you seen her? Her cows are loose, all of them.
Come on. Tell her.
I'd left my wrenches earlier in the day when I was working on your front loader, remember?
Okay.
I needed them tonight to work on Mr. Thorne's forklift and
Pete, please.
Okay, well, before I could see the sign to your ranch, all I could see was cows everywhere.
Oh, no.
Wait, Kendall. Wait, Kendall. Wait, stop. Kendall, you left your purse!
On the road. Clint? Clint! Hey! Hey!
Oh, sorry I didn't call.
Oh! Come here.
It was my dad.
I know.
And Hank. I tried to stop him.
I know, it's okay.
The cattle, they're all gone.
It's okay, I know. Come here. Hey. You okay? Clint? Oh. Clint? Oh! Clint!
Clint, hey,
talk to me. Clint, what happened?
Is this the price you're willing to pay for my ranch? Is this the price?
They didn't recognize him. They couldn't have known it was him. They couldn't have known.
They knew. They knew, McCree.
Clint, hang on, son. Hang on.
I don't remember punching you in the eye.
Lillian, she slammed the door in my face.
The doctor says he'll be okay. He just needs to rest.
Do you know how your ranch got its name?
My dad went all in. It was his last chance.
Nope. Lillian named it before she sold it to him. She said it was a message to me. It meant that I had one last chance to make things right with Clint and with her. It appears I have lost that chance.
You may have shaped them into who they are. They aren't you.
You are so much like her, you know. Your mom.
Is that why you're so good to me?
It's why I'm so hard on you. It's why I can barely stand and look at you sometimes.
Then don't look at me. Don't come near me. Let me run my ranch in peace.
I don't understand what you hope to accomplish. There's no money in what you want. There's no future.
I do it for the money.
Then what?
I do it for my parents. because they believed in me. I do it for my friends because they inspired me. I do it for God, for everything he's given me. I do it for my kids, who will one day say, my grandfather rode here. My mother fought for here. I grew up here. I do it for people, Mr. McCree. Why do you do it?
I can't think of a reason good enough to mention. Maybe your father was lucky you took it over.
Well, none of that matters now, does it? My cows are scattered everywhere. I have a buyer coming and nothing to sell them. I can't leave Clint like this. And even with my few cowhands working all night, we still won't make it.
When's he coming?
About 2 hours or so. There's just no way. My whole herd is scattered for miles.
They say he'll be okay. Exhaustion, concussion. They beat him up pretty bad.
Oh, I just dare one of those bandits to sit in my chair.
Hey, I'm under here.
Ask and you shall receive.
Please get him out from under that mistletoe.
Nice, Shana. You hear the door?
Yep, I need your help.
Why on earth would we ever help you? Don't you cut your own hair.
I need y'all to help me help Kendall.
Don't trust him.
No, listen to me. You people are good for one thing and one thing only, and for once in somebody's life, she needs it, so... Seriously, you don't know what you're good at? Gossip. So get ready to open up your Rolodexes. Kendall needs help.
Maybe I can lease part of it.
No.
Or Marcus said I could amputate a portion.
Kendall, no.
Hey, calm down. Please, you need to rest.
How can I rest when she's losing her ranch?
Whoa. Looks could kill.
Who needs looks when you got mom? Pow.
Yeah, never mind that. I deserve it, but I'm making up for it. Come on.
What did you do?
Let's get him up. Come on, let's go. I gotta show you something. Come on, get him up. Get him up! Let's go! Come on!
Joe. I'm okay.
What exactly are we looking for?
Hold on now. You see that?
Yeah! Wow!
Here they come. I had the gossips call everyone from five counties to get your cattle back, kid. I'm sorry for all the trouble I caused you, Kendall. Merry Christmas, son. Pretty good, huh? I told them it was for your daddy. They all come out.
I don't believe it.
181. 182. It's 183. Hello, Bernadette. How you feeling, girl? 184 and 185.
20 more head up in the back pasture.
Thank you.
Shut the gate.
It's almost all of them.
We did it.
You did it.
So, are you gonna help?
I could help.
Second Chance Ranch. Merry Christmas, sir.
Humbug, Pete.
I knew you'd be here.
Hi.
Walk with me. Listen, I have a proposal.
A proposal?
Well, more like an idea. Thinking of sticking around.
Really?
You know, in case you need an on-call veterinarian.
I was hoping for full-time.
Full-time? You're gonna have a hard time finding someone this time of year.
Lucky for me that you're here.
Kendall, the Second Chance Ranch should be back in the family again.
I never thought of it that way. I know you wouldn't kiss me if I told you I was dying. What if I told you I was ready to start living again?
Well, you'd have to break up with your mistress.
What?
The ranch. Hand it over to somebody.
Oh, my goodness. You actually think Kalina's ready for that?
I do not.
Kendall.
You think you got what it takes to go organic?
I don't know. I suppose I could entertain the idea. If she was a McCree.
And the box. With all those memories.
What do you say we bury it together on Christmas morning? Well, thanks for making sure my son didn't turn out like me.
You're welcome.
Like we got a 12.
A 12?
A happily ever after.